Okay, everybody, welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. Today we're going to be looking at how to download and install Minecraft Education for the iPad. Now let's get things started by going over to the App Store and typing in Minecraft Education in the search bar. Now when the little bookshelf with the green background pops up, you're going to hit download on that one. That's the one that we want, okay? Now it will take a moment to download and install, but it will do that automatically. So I'm just going to skip forward a little bit in the video and we will click open and then move to the next stage. Okay, so the download's finished and the install as well. So we're going to click open and load up the program. Now before this next set of instructions, you will need some details from either your ICT teacher, your computing teacher, or your IT admin at the school or company where you work to get your username and password. But once you have those, just enter them in. I've blurred out mine because I don't want everyone knowing my username and password. But if you do have any problems accessing those, just double check your internet connection, double check you're spelling everything correctly, and then if that fails, contact your teacher or IT support just to make sure they've got enough licenses and that it's all working, all right? Now, when we first load up the app, we got to the home screen here. The first thing that Microsoft suggests you do is click the little coat hanger down there and change your skin and select one that you want to use. I suggest going into lessons, going to the library, going to the lessons, just having a dig around. Everything's organized into subjects. So if you want to click those and have a look, it will give you a description of the lesson. And then it will also, if you click create world, you can go into the lesson and have a play around with it and just choose the kind of stuff that you want to do with your class. Now, the first thing I recommend doing if you're in a computing lesson and you're new to the iPad is certainly to go to, we're going to go to lessons and we're going to go to the library, how to play, start here, and we're going to work our way through the tutorials there, particularly the one that says touch controls. That's a useful one. But for now, we're going to have a look through the first tutorial, which is called Movements, and we'll see how it works for users of the iPad, okay? Now, as we go through this, we want to read the instructions, obviously. We want to select these gold blocks. Now, when you touch the screen like this, you will get a circle that appears, but we don't want to get that circle on the gold block. We want to get the gold block in the center of the screen by dragging and moving our view around. So we'll do those four, turn around and get the last one, and this little cage here is going to open up so we can walk through. Now the up, down, left, right arrows will move us around, and as well as using those, we need to keep dragging our finger across the screen to get our character looking and pointing in the right direction, okay? So kind of the point of this lesson is really getting the students used to doing those two things at once, which can be quite tricky. I know many students will have used Pocket Edition before, but not all of them. Now, if anyone of your students are finding this difficult, or you're finding it difficult, you can go into settings and you can change it so that the arrows are on the right side and then you used your left hand to drag around the screen. So left-handed people might find that a little bit easier. So as you make your way through this level, there's a few obstacle courses just to get used to it, but you come out of this little section here and you can exit the lesson by pressing the pause button and pressing save and exit. However, we're going to have a little look at the chat commands, so we'll hit the little chat bubble at the top. Because what's interesting that is in the iPad version, you get these little blocks of commands, so you can access the commands quite quickly. So you can see here, just a couple of touches, now I was able to change it to sunset, and there's a one for teleport as well, and set world spawn point. More than that, you need to type it in, so we'll just do a give command here, and you'll notice it does auto-complete at the top, which is useful, but it would be really nice if you could actually touch those auto-completed bits of code to make it complete in the text box at the bottom there. That would be nice. You can't do that, unfortunately, so we're just going to type out give at a arrow, and that will pop into our inventory. Just like it would in the normal version. Okay, so the coding elements, the command elements, I should say, all seem to work exactly the same. So let's save and exit, head out of this particular tutorial. Now, next, we're going to go into this big creative world that I've created, an infinite world, just to look at the inventory. Now, to access the inventory, it's a few little dots next to the hotbar at the bottom right. And then if you just hit search, I'm just going to show you how to move things into the inventory. Now, what I'm trying to do at the moment is drag those blocks down. Actually, that doesn't work. What you need to do is touch them to select them and then touch to your hotbar where you want, which slot you want those blocks to go in. And if I fly down here, you can see if I just tap once, it will place those blocks. And if I tap and hold, it'll dig those blocks away and mine them away. Now, a couple of other things to note about the touch interface. You can see at the top middle there, we've got a little picture of the agent. So you can do all the coding stuff the same. If you hit the agent, you can go into Microsoft MakeCode or into Tinker and do some of the tutorials on there. That's always a really good way to get into the coding element. And the other big thing I noticed, I'm kind of middle clicking to pick blocks and move them into your hotbar. I couldn't find a way to do that. But apparently you can connect a controller up to your iPad. So if you've got a controller for something lying around, a wireless controller, you could connect that and go into the settings and set it up. So if you had students that had access to things like that and really wanted to use those features, you could certainly look into that for them. Now, we are going to be looking, in a further video, we're going to be looking at more sustainability city that we started last week. So we'll do the second lesson of that. So please make sure, if you liked today's video and you want to see more upcoming videos, like and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you all next time.